Dear students, welcome to e-Shikshana program. I am Dr. V. Ramachandramurthy, Professor of Mathematics, RR Institute of Technology, Bangalore. First of all, I would like to thank the authorities of VTU for identifying me as one of the subject experts to take part in this prestigious e-Shikshana program. I thank our management, principal, RR Institute of Technology for their continuous support and encouragement throughout my career. I will be dealing with Module 3, Ordinary Differential Equations of First Order of First Semester Mathematics Course, Calculus and Differential Equations bearing code 21 MAT 11. Before I start the prescribed syllabus, let me give a brief introduction on the subject differential equations. Most of the problems that arise in oscillations of mechanical and electrical systems, bending of beams, velocity of chemical reactions, heat conduction, heats a differential equation in one way or the other form. The solution of differential equation plays a very important role in order to understand the behavior of the system of the problem. So let us first understand the differential equations. Differential equation is an equation involving differentials or differential coefficients. So let me write down the definition of differential equation. Differential equation It is an equation involving differentials or differential coefficients. Differentials are differential coefficients. Differential equation in which all the differential coefficients have reference to one single independent variable is called as ordinary differential equation. Differential equations involving two or more independent variables and partial differential coefficients with respect to any one of them or with respect to all is called as partial differential equations. So ordinary differential equation. The definition of ordinary differential equation is differential equations in which differential equation in which all the differential coefficients. Have reference to a single independent variable, is called as ordinary differential equation. The another differential equation is partial differential equation. Differential equation involving independent variables and partial differential coefficients and partial differential coefficients with respect to any one of them or with respect to all is called a partial differential equation. So in general, we denote ordinary differential equation by ODE, partial differential equation by PDE. Okay, let us understand the order and degree of the differential equation. Order and degree of a differential equation is defined like this. Order of a differential equation is the order of the highest derivative that present in the differential equation, and the degree of the differential equation is defined as the degree of the highest derivative that present in the differential equation after the equation has been expressed free from radicals and fractions as far as the differential coefficients are concerned. So it is defined like this: order a differential equation, the order of a differential equation, differential equation, is the order of the differential equation, is the order of the x derivative, is the order of the highest derivative that present in a in the differential equation in a. The degree of the differential equation is the degree of the highest derivative that present in it after the equation, this differential equation, after the equation has been expressed free from radicals, and fractions, as far as the differential coefficients are concerned, differential coefficients are concerned. So let me give you some example on the following: order, degree, and two different types of differential equations. So consider the example. Consider the following examples. One, e power x dx plus e power y dy is equal to 0. Second example, d square y dx square plus n square y is equal to 0. Y is equal to x into dy by dx minus x divided by dy by dx, 1 plus dy by dx the whole square raised to the power 3 by 2 is equal to a into d square y by dx square, d square y by dx square. Example 5, x into dou u by dou x plus y into dou u by dou y is equal to 1 into u. Sixth example, dou square u by dou x square plus dou square u by dou y square plus dou square u by dou z square equal to 0. Now let me explain all this differential equation. As you see, the example 1 is an ordinary differential equation, and example 2 is also an ordinary differential equation because both involves the independent variable, single independent variable x. Example 3 is also ordinary differential equation. Example 4 also ordinary differential equation, whereas example 5 and 6 are partial differential equations because differential equation 5 involves two independent variables, and equation 6 involves three independent variables. So 5 and 6 are the partial differential equations. Okay. So now let us discuss the order and degree of each equation. Example 1 is an ordinary differential equation of order 1 and degree also equal to 1. Example 2 is an ordinary differential equation of order 2 and degree 1. And 3 is an ordinary differential equation of order 1, but degree we have to see because this involves a fraction. So equation 3 can be written as y by multiplying throughout by dy by dx, thereby I will be removing the fraction 1 over dy by dx. So if I multiply throughout by dy by dx, so I get y into dy by dx is equal to x into dy by dx the whole square minus x. Okay, so now order of the differential equation is 1 and degree of the differential equation is 2. So example 3 is an ordinary differential equation of order 1 and degree 2. Similarly, fourth order differential equation as a radical. So if I simplify example 4 order differential equation, that means squaring both sides, so I get 1 plus dy by dx whole square raised to the power 3 is equal to a square into d square y by dx square whole square. Now this is free from radical, and this is order differential equation of order 2 and degree also equal to 2. So example 5 is a partial differential equation of order 1, degree 1, and example 6 is a partial differential equation of order 2 and degree 1. Okay. Now let us look at the solution of the differential equation. What is the solution of a differential equation? Solution of a differential equation is the relation between the variables. That satisfies the differential equation. Solution of differential equation. Solution of a differential equation. Solution of a differential equation. Solution of a differential equation is a relation between the variables that satisfies it. A very simple definition. Solution of a differential equation of a differential equation is a relation between the variables. That satisfy it. That satisfy it. So it is a relation between the variables that satisfy the given differential equation, or that satisfy it. General solution. Let us look at the general solution now. General solution. It is a solution, first of all, in which the number of arbitrary constants is equal to the order of the differential equation. A general solution. A general solution, or this is also called as complete solution, or complete solution, is first of all a solution, is a solution in which the number of arbitrary constants is equal to the order of the differential equation, which the number of arbitrary constants is equal to the order of the differential equation. Order of the differential equation. Order of the differential equation. Now, let me define particular solution. Particular solution. Particular solution is again a solution which is derived from general solution or complete solution by assigning particular values to the arbitrary constants. A particular solution is a solution. A solution which can be obtained, by giving or assigning particular values. To the arbitrary constants. Okay. Now let me give you an example. Example 1, y is equal to cos x plus some arbitrary constant c is a solution of dy by dx plus sin x is equal to 0 plus sin x equal to 0. Now, as I told you, solution of a differential equation is a relation between the variables that satisfy it, and this is the solution of this. That means they should satisfy this differential equation. Now let me substitute this in the differential equation. That means I have to differentiate once dy by dx is equal to minus sin x plus 0. Now substitute one. So therefore, if you substitute it in this equation, differential equation, minus sin x plus sin x, that is equal to 0. So it satisfies the differential equation. Therefore, this is the solution of this differential equation. In particular, this is the general solution. If I assign values to C, let us say C is equal to pi. So y is equal to cos x plus pi or any other value. Again, it satisfies, becomes a particular solution of this differential equation itself. C is taking the value pi, is a particular solution, of dy by dx plus sin x equal to 0. So this is the general solution. Number of arbitrary constant is equal to 1. Order of the differential equation is also equal to 1. So it is a general solution, and this is the particular solution of the same differential equation. Now let me consider example 2. X is equal to A times cos nt plus some constant b is a general solution, of d square x by dt square plus n square x equal to 0. Now this is a general solution. As we discussed here, this has to satisfy this differential equation. Similarly, this satisfies this differential equation. Okay. So let us find out how it happens here. So differentiate x with respect to t twice. So differentiation of cos is minus sine. So minus a into sine nt plus b into differentiation of nt plus b with respect to t, that is n. Again, if you differentiate once again, d square x by dt square is equal to differentiation of sine is plus cos. So minus a cos nt plus b plus into n into another n, so it is n square. Now, just substitute in this equation. Minus a into n square, right? That is d square x by dt square, minus n square into, let me write like this, minus n square into a cos of nt plus b plus n square into x, multiply n square to this, plus n square into a into cos nt plus b is 0. So this satisfies this equation. So therefore, this is called the solution of this differential equation, as it involves two arbitrary constants, which is equal to the order of the differential equation. So this is the general solution of this differential equation. If you assign values to arbitrary constants, let us say x is equal to a into cos nt plus pi by 4. So v is taking a particular value, pi by 4 is a particular solution, is a particular solution of this differential equation of d square x by dt square plus n square x equal to 0. A differential equation may have sometimes additional solution which cannot be obtained from the general or complete solution by assigning particular values to the arbitrary constants. Such solutions are called singular solutions. So let me define singular solution. Singular solution. A differential equation may have sometimes a differential equation. Differential equation may have sometimes an additional solution which cannot be obtained which cannot be obtained from the general solution or complete solution. General solution. By assigning particular values to arbitrary constants. Such a solution is called or is known as a singular solution. Now with this background, let me start your first year BE Mathematics course, module 3 of Calculus and Differential Equations chapter. Your syllabus starts from a linear equation. So let me first define what is the linear equation. A linear equation is a differential equation in which the dependent variables and its derivatives occur always in first degree and are not multiplied together. So let me define a linear equation. A differential equation a differential equation is said to be linear if the dependent variable, a differential equation is said to be linear if the dependent variable and its derivatives occur only in first degree and are not multiplied together thus the standard form of a linear equation standard form of a linear equation of the first order commonly known as Leibniz linear equation. Leibniz linear equation is dy by dx plus p into y is equal to q. Where capital P and Q are functions of x only. Such a differential equation is called a Leibniz linear equation, which is an ordinary differential equation of order 1 and degree 1. The solution of Leibniz linear equation equation is given by y into if stands for integrating factor. Y into if is equal to integral q into integrating factor dx plus integral constant c. So where if where integrating factor, IF is equal to e power integral p dx. So with this, we can solve some of the differential equations. So let me consider one or two examples and then proceed to the next topic. Solve x plus 1 into dy by dx minus y is equal to e power 3x into x plus 1 whole square. So the solution part, the given differential equation is x plus 1 into dy by dx minus y is equal to e power 3x into x plus 1 whole square. Let us bring it to the forum. Our Lagrange linear equation is dy by dx plus p into y is equal to q. So let us make the coefficient of dy by dx 1. So that means I have to multiply or divide by x plus 1 through divide by x plus 1 throughout. So I get dy by dx minus y divided by x plus 1 is equal to, so you can cancel out factor, it is e power 3x into x plus 1. Okay, this is exactly the standard form, dy by dx minus py, so your p is minus 1 by x plus 1. A q is e power 3x into x plus 1. So which is a Lagrange linear equation, which is a Lagrange linear equation. Here, p is minus 1 divided by x plus 1, and q is e power 3x into x plus 1. Okay, let me call this as equation number 1. So since 1 is a Lagrange linear equation, we know its solution. Its solution is y into integrating factor is equal to integration of q into integrating factor plus some arbitrary constant c. The solution of y, solution of y is given by y into integrating factor is equal to q into integrating factor dx plus some marginal constant c. Now let us calculate integrating factor first. Integrating factor if is equal, call this as equation number 2, is equal to e power integral p dx. This is equal to e power integral p is minus 1 by x plus 1. So minus dx divided by x plus 1. So this is equal to e power integration of 1 by x plus 1 is log x plus 1. So minus log of x plus 1, and this can be written as x plus 1 power minus 1 or 1 by x plus 1, because a power x can be written as e power x into log a. Now substitute if in 1. Substitute in 2. So y into integrating factor x plus 1 power minus 1 or 1 by x plus 1 y by x plus 1 is equal to integral q e power 3x into x plus 1 is your q into integrating factor is x plus 1 power minus 1 dx plus integral constant c. Now, so this can be written as y divided by x plus 1. Y divided by x plus 1 is equal to, so this can, you can cancel x plus 1 by x plus 1. So you are left with integral e power 3x dx plus arbitrary constant c. The integration of e power 3x is e power 3x divided by 3 plus c. So y, or this can be written as y is equal to x plus 1 into e power 3x divided by 3 plus c is the required general solution of the given differential equation, which is the required solution, or in particular general solution, which is the required general solution. General solution of the given differential equation. Given differential equation. So let me consider another example. Example 2, solve 1 plus y square into dx is equal to tan inverse y minus x into dy. Now let me rewrite this equation. So the given differential equation is 1 plus y square dx is equal to tan inverse y minus x into dy. So this is the given differential equation. So I can conveniently write this as dy by dx is equal to 1 plus y square divided by tan inverse y minus x. So by considering this way, it is not possible to reduce it to this form, dy by dx plus py is equal to q, where p and q are functions of x only. So what I will do, I will reciprocate both sides, reciprocating both sides, I get dx by dy is equal to tan inverse y minus x divided by 1 plus y square. So this can be brought to the form dx by dy plus px is equal to q, where q and p are functions of y. In that case, this can be called as Leibniz linear equation in x. So just see how this can be reduced to that form dx by dy is equal to divide each term by the denominator tan inverse y divided by 1 plus y square minus x divided by 1 plus y square. Now further, I will take the last term to the left hand side. Further, I will take dx by dy plus x divided by 1 plus y square is equal to tan inverse y divided by 1 plus y square. This is exactly a Leibniz linear equation in x, which is all this as equation 1, which is a Leibniz linear equation in x, and hence its general solution, its solution, and hence its solution is given by, now x into integrity factor, x into if is equal to q into integrating factor. Now with respect to y, look at this and decide which one to write, dy plus some integral constant c. Now let me first find out this integrating factor if is integral e power integral p. So what is p here? Let me write p. So here p is 1 divided by 1 plus y square, and q is tan inverse y divided by 1 plus y square. Okay. So integrating factor is e power integral p dy, that is e power integral dy divided by 1 plus y square. So integration of 1 by 1 plus x square is tan inverse x. So this is equal to e power tan inverse y. Now let me substitute this in equation 2. Substitute in equation 2. So x into e power tan inverse y is equal to integral q. Q is tan inverse y divided by 1 plus y square into if. If is e power tan inverse y dy plus iterator constants. Now, to integrate this, let us go for substitution, because differentiation of tan inverse y is 1 by 1 plus y square. So, I will replace and consider the transformation or substitution. Put t is equal to tan inverse y. What is the differential of this? Differential of t is differential of tan inverse y is 1 divided by 1 plus y square into t. Now substitute in this equation. Substitute in this equation. So x into e power tan inverse y, the right hand side only, substitution, x into e power tan inverse y is equal to integral. Tan inverse y is t, e power tan inverse y is e power t, dy by 1 plus y square is dt plus c. They are very simple integration by parts. If you carefully integrate by parts, taking t as the first function and e power t as the second function, so applying general rule by parts. What is the general rule? Integration of general rule by parts. Integration of u into v dx is first function into integration of second function v1 minus differentiation of the first function, integration of the second function twice, that is v2, all my alternate sign minus plus, then u double dash v3 minus etc. So if you apply this general rule of integration by parts, taking t as the first function, v as the second function, your LHS x into e power tan inverse y is equal to first function is t, integration of second function e power t with respect to t is e power t only, minus differentiation of first function t is 1 with respect to t, integration of v1 to get v2, that is integration of e power t with respect to t is e power t only. So there hence the terms gets terminated here, because u dash is 1, u double dash is 0, so you don't get any other terms plus arbitrary constants. Now substitute for c. So before that we can make some simplification. So this can be written as x into e power tan inverse y. Tan inverse y is equal to t minus 1 into e power t plus c. Now substitute for t. So x into e power tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse y minus 1 e power tan inverse y plus some constant c. Okay. So this is the required solution. In case this can also be rewritten as x is equal to tan inverse y minus 1 plus c into e power minus tan inverse y by multiplying throughout by e power minus tan inverse y. So which is the required solution, in particular a general solution, which is the required solution, which is the required solution of the given differential equation. Given differential equation. Given differential equation. Now this is about solving the first order ordinary differential equation, namely Leibniz linear equations. I will conclude my lecture today. Now, the next class, I will continue the remaining topics. Thank you.